actually happening. So biological energy is turned, chemical energy is turned into biological. It's quite incredible. We have a creator. Now, this creator can communicate. Now, here's a book I've read. It took me 50 hours. I've read the Quran. Now, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Who's the King of Kings? I'm just some bloke called Dave from South London. So who is the actual King of Kings? Who made everything? What do you think?
I don't think there is a King of Kings.
You don't think there's a creator of creation?
I don't think there is a creator of creation.
So the incredible engineering of your brain, the most incredible thing in the universe is between your ears. You believe that the incredible DNA within your blood system, which has an intricate, complex, irreducibly linked ingenuity that has been designed and engineered, has come from nothing. Do you believe that?
We have watched evolution in different aisles before.
You've thrown out a word evolution. Answer the question. You believe that this ingenious DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, okay,
yes,
it's irreducibly complex and it has an incredibly complex code that even Billy Gates has said way better than any computer. You believe that this has come from a dead rock which exploded 13.7 billion years ago?
Yes.
You do. Can you explain how a dead rock 13.7 billion years ago produces DNA?
Well, it's a natural reaction, isn't it?
Sorry?
It's a natural reaction.
A natural reaction to a dead rock exploding.
Yes, amino acids.
Sorry?
Amino acids.
No. In the beginning, you have a total vacuum. According to the theory, Stephen Hawking, have you heard of the guy?
Yeah.
Okay. Stephen Hawking and his ilk, what they believe, what they preach, they say there was a total vacuum, a total nothingness. And from that came time, space, and matter. And this infinitesimally small, super dense thing, which was dead, no life, it was dead, now you're alive. Now, do you believe in magic? You do. You believe that a dead rock will produce you.
All right, but if you say that, what proof do you have is that the creator created this dead rock?
Okay, now we're talking. Right. So we get rid of the fairy tale. We get rid of the fairy tale. The Frogosaurus will turn into Prince Harry fairy tale. Yeah, frog into a prince. Get rid of that. Right. Now proper science. Okay. Deoxyribonucleic acid. You have a cell. A human cell in your body, you've got billions of them, okay? They have an intricate, complex, irreducibly linked, you can't wait millions of years for this to come along, made together, mature, okay? They have the complexity of a city. Its own transportation system, communication system, refuse system, within a cell. What did Charlie Darwin call it? A simple cell. Wrong. He was wrong. It's an incredibly complex piece of kit. That's just your cell. Wow. Now, we have an incredible designer who's given us the ability to read. Name an animal that can read the works of Shakespeare or the Quran or the Bible.
There isn't.
There isn't. No. So we're clearly not animals. You're wearing clothes. Name an animal that puts clothes on in the morning. None. Can you name me an animal that gets soul music? Yeah? Dancing around to the beat, gets it, you know. No, so they don't get music. Animals don't get music.
There is animals.
Oh, they appreciate the Philharmonic Orchestra.
There's animals that communicate via rhythm. Have you heard of a kakapo?
Oh, that's different. Rhythm, frequency is very different to music as we know it. It's very different. So, okay, animals don't get music, really. Deep down. They don't get dressed. And they don't get jokes. That's just three things. Come on, you're a human being. Now, you've been told lies about this book. Guaranteed you've been lied. I was when I was younger, hundreds of years ago, when I was 19 years old, I believed in me, myself, and I. Me, myself, and I. Did I believe in God? Hello? Where are you? No, I believe in me, myself, and I. But I thought, hang on a minute, I'll give this book a read. So I checked out this book. I was livid reading this book. My mama, who is deceased, she is no more. She told me, Dave, Pitt, you got to go to school. It's a Catholic school. You've got to go to church every week, Catholic. Lies, 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 lies. You do not pray to Mary. You don't pray to Mary, that's a load of garbage. You don't tell your sins to a bloke in a little room in a black dress. He's in there, you got to go in there by yourself with a bloke in a black dress. You got to tell him all the naughty things you've done. And then, once he's finished his Guinness, well, one of the priests is called Father McGuinness, that's it. Anyway, so, he said, oh, you naughty boy. Go and pray to Mary. Go and pray to Mary, go on. So anyway, his main man was this dude. Fake. Come on, read the book. Now, what is the main message in the book? You don't know. It's called the Gospel. It's not Gospel according to Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. No. It's the actual main message Gospel. Euangelion, which is a Greek word. You're learning today. A little bit of Greek. Euangelion. Do you know what it is? It's that Christ died, the Messiah, gave his life on the cross to take the punishment for your sin, my sin, his sin, everyone's sin. He took the punishment for sin according to the prophecies, because he had to, at a certain time according to the prophet Daniel, okay? And he had to rise from the dead according to the prophet David, King David, etc. Right, now if you believe in him as your Lord, your King, take off your own crown, put it on him. If you believe in him as your Lord and Savior, that's a done deal. You get given the Spirit of God. Do you have God's Spirit? No, you don't. You're trying to enjoy yourself, but you can't enjoy life until you have God's Spirit, God's peace, God's love, God's joy deep in your heart. You ain't going to have that until you believe in him as your King. It's very simple. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you'll be saved. How complex is that?
Can I ask you a question?
That, one more from him and then back to you.
How come I enjoy life then?
How come
I enjoy life?
Did you say how come I endure life?
How come I
you
enjoy life?
You do endure life.
Yeah,
you endure life.
Yeah, I don't think
you
I
You try
Jesus
and enjoy, life. But you actually endure life. To be honest, come on.
No.
You don't know who you are.
Oh, I know who I am.
Well, you think you're an animal, but you're actually not. So you're a little bit confused about it. You don't know where you come from. You think you came from an explosion of a dead rock. Not quite right. You don't know where you're going, so you don't know who you are, present, where you come from, where you go. But you're trying to enjoy life, and I'm sure you enjoy some things. You love music, you love a drink, you love playing games. Now, but you can really enjoy and endure when you know who you are and where you're going.
The prophet.
Because the one who said, I am the life, who's that? I am the truth. Who's that? His name is the Lord Jesus Christ. The Muslims don't believe his name is Lord Jesus Christ.
Another question.
They believe his name is Jesus Christ. He's called Lord King 700 times. Why would they change the Bible 700 times? Because it doesn't fit with Mohammed, does it? What he said. Because he said, no, his name is Jesus.
Can I ask something?
I have another
question. How many Bibles do you have?
Last question, and then this man.
So you said all that stuff about the space rock expanding doesn't make any real sense.
The space what?
You were talking about the space rock and, you know...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and you said, but you haven't given me an alternative theory. And you said, how did he create all? And who created God, if so?
The fancy term, this is what they say. I've debated at universities, a professor and students at university. Big Bang versus Big God, okay? Creation versus evolution. It's a very, very key topic, right? Now, according to the theory, it's called a theory, the Big Bang theory, yeah? It's a theory, absolutely, yeah. God is a theory as well. The creator is a theory. So according to that theory, it's called the singularity. The singular, it sounds good, doesn't it? This singularity, dead rock thing came out of nowhere, okay? And it's called a mass expansion. Let's not call it an explosion, because all explosions destroy life. Let's call it a mass expansion. Now, according to that theory, life came into being. Happy days. Right, okay. Now, I believe in science, proper science. I know PhDs. I don't have a PhD. I've got 3 degrees, and it's a fantastic album. Have you ever heard the album by the 3 degrees? It's really good. Anyway, so, the creation. Photosynthesis. Chemical energy is turning into biological energy, feeding that tree. giving out oxygen, feeding you. When you feed yourself, the digestive system alone would convince me there's a God. Because it gets in your blood, man. It gets in your blood. You know what I'm saying? Media's messing with your mind, man. Media's telling you that you came from nothing. Come on, you got a brain. Use your brain. Admit you may have been deluded. Now come to the truth. Now, the key thing is there's a creator of creation. There's an engineer of the engineered. Yeah? So there's an incredible artist behind the artistry of life. It's all in the name, very simple, cause and effect. And it's the God of the Bible, I believe.
You explained the universe is still expanding, you know? Right. You look out with a telescope, the universe is still expanding. How do you explain that?
Because
there was no expansion. What you're saying.
You've just stepped into a realm of science fiction. What you've said there is not exactly true. What people observe is blue shift and red shift. Which is the faster? The red shift. Well done. You know your stuff. The red shift. Things moving out very far. Blue shift. Moving out slowly. What does that mean? That means that the Bible is absolutely spot on when it says that God throughout the expanse of the universe. So he set things in motion doing that. Doesn't mean it came from something infinitesimally small. Would you Adam and Eve it? I would. There's a bloke called Adam and Eve, and God said, I've invented a thing called sex. Enjoy yourself. Have loads of kids. Don't have 2.5 kids. Multiply. So they did. They had loads. Probably had about 100 kids. That's where we came from. A super intelligent designer. So, the Catholics are wrong. The Jehovah's Witnesses are wrong. The Mormons are wrong. The Orthodox are wrong. Most Protestants are wrong. How do I know? Read the book. What does the book say? It says that you can be forgiven. It's God's deal. He cut a deal throughout the whole book. Now, the ultimate deal is with the Mashiach, the Messiah. He's come. Israel. Have you heard of a place called Israel? Yeah, of course. Sorry. Condescending, sorry. I lived there for 2 years. Israel, it's a real country, spoke to Muslims, Jews, you name it, all sorts of people. People from all over the world. Right. Sorry? It's not a real country. Okay, some people think it doesn't exist. Okay. Now, I've been into the Palestinian territories as well. I was there a couple of, about months ago. And I spoke to real people who know that the Palestinian territories now exist and Israel exists. Now, in the Bible, it's called the God of Israel. 300 times he's called the God of Israel. Why? Where does Israel come from? Have you heard of a guy called Yaqub? Yaqub? You've heard of Yaqub. You should do. If you're a Muslim, you should have heard of Yaqub. Jacob, right? He's a Jewish guy. Jacob, yeah, the tribe of... Anyway, so Jacob, he wrestled with God. He struggled with God. And then God changed his name to Israel. That's where the name comes from. It means struggle of God. So the Messiah has come. 2022 years ago, a certain bloke was born in Bethlehem Ephrathah. Specific place in Bethlehem where the Messiah had to be born. According to the prophecy in Micah 5:2. So he was born there. Is Christmas real? No, it's pagan. Is Easter real? No, it's pagan. Are all the Jewish people? Yeah, they are. I ain't Jewish. I've got a bit of Viking in me. I've got a little bit of Irish, so I have. That's all that Catholic rubbish.
Are you the true king?
Hang on a sec.
Saying one thing, like even in the Torah, like there's a difference between being Jewish and there's a difference between being Zionist. Like even in the Torah, Jews are supposed to be exiled, right?
Most people don't know this stuff about Zionism and Judaism.
So this is where it comes in. Like if you're going based on religious text, which is your argument, you can't say Israel exists because technically Israel is not a Jewish state; it's a Zionist state. Right. So this is where you're mixing
what
up.
Was it called, what was it called originally?
Palestine.
No. It was called Ka'anan. Do you know, have you heard of the word Canaan? Yeah? There were a bunch of dodgy freaks, man. They were doing some crazy shish kebab there. God said, you, Ibrahim, Avram, I am going to give you a place, the promised land. I'm going to reveal my name in Shiloh, Yerushalayim, and all the other cities. I will give to you If you go in there and you get rid of these freaks, these crazy, evil people. Now, from that, we have all the tribes of Israel. Now, when I read the Quran, it took me 5 hours. What do they keep talking about? The Israelites, the Israelites, the Israelites. It's in the Quran. You've not read the Quran. You're wearing a face nappy. He wears a face nappy. I don't talk to people.
Oh,
you've got some courage. You might get a disease taking your nappy off. Hang on. Anyway, we'll stick to the point. So, the Israelites.
Yes, they used to.
You know, we've got to go back to the origins. And what did God do? He gave it the name Judah Israel. And then he had a guy called Saul, who was the first king. He was a dodgy king. Most of the kings of Israel were dodgy. They were crazy. Why am I starting to talk like Donald Trump? I don't know. That's a bit weird. Sorry. Anyway, I got a little bit sidetracked. So, most of the kings of Israel, dodgy. Seriously dodgy. Okay? They were Israel, not Australia. Some people are very confused. Right, now, God says do this. So they went, no. We're going to do whatever we want, mate. You know what? I'm the king now, I'll do what. Dodgy. But some of them were good. Melech David, King David, now he was good.
Was he?
He wasn't perfect. He messed up. But he was good. He was a man after God's own heart. You can know God heart to heart. Not mosque to heart. Not church to heart. Heart to heart. In your heart, he made it. He knows more in your head, in your heart, than you do.
Prove it.
He designed it. He proved it. He came to Israel, lived there for 33 years. 3 years did a whole ton of miracles.
Yeah, that's
pretty good.
You're trying to overwhelm people with facts. I'm trying to give you facts
you've never heard before, because the mainstream media, the BBC, the Beelzebub Broadcasting Corporation, the Bias Broadcasting Corporation, will never tell you the gospel. They'll tell you about the Pope. There's no hope for the Pope. He can't cope. He's on dope. And yet they say, here's your Christianity. Thank you, BBC. That's a load of BS.
They
should get you on instead of the Archbishop of Canterbury.
The fact that you said Israel is a real state, it's not based on like what was said. And
based
you
on
no, no, and you supported
135 AD.
No, but you also support Hebrew film. It's also based on what you said in terms of it's called the Israelites and what's supposed to be.
In the Quran, Israelites. Keep going on about the Israelites.
Even in the Quran, it's supposed to be.
No, it's just the Jews.
All religions coexist together. It's supposed to be a land of peace.
Have you read the Quran? Yes. All religions to coexist together.
Well,
you sure you've read the Quran? You've read the Hadiths as well, have you? Okay. Are you Sunni, Shiite?
Which one?
Sunni. Both. You're both. You're mixed. Okay. Very interesting. Now I've read the book, and it really gave a different kind of impression to me from what it was. Now I've read the Bible, and it says the Messiah had to do something amazing. What did he do? He walked on water. Well done. He did a few miracles. Well done. No. The Messiah has to bring total victory to the Jews. What did he do? He failed. If he didn't bring victory in their hearts, he did. He defeated sin. He defeated death. That's what the Messiah had to do, according to Isaiah 53. Yeshayahu Hamashin. Shalosh. He had to bring victory, take the punishment for sin. If you believe that Yesu, Ibn Miriam Yesu al-Masih, so he's the Messiah. He has to bring victory. You don't even believe he's the Messiah. You've got to believe in him as the proper Messiah. He rose from the dead. Sorry. You what? I know. You should, if you're a Muslim, you should believe him as prophet. And Messiah, Mashiach. If you're a proper Muslim, he's the Messiah.
We don't have a Messiah. We have
what? Yeah, you get, there are loads of fake messiahs. You need the real one. Go ahead. It's not an ideology. I'm trying to reason with people. In the Bible it says a debate. Reason with people. This is what we're doing. I'm trying to help you. I don't get money for that. I go all over the world. I'm going to Germany next. I came back from Israel and the Palestinian territories about 3 months ago. I go different countries around the world. I'm in the streets about 4 or 5 times a week, speak to people from all different religions and ethnicity and whatever. I do this as a full-time thing. I've done it for 15 years, okay? So this is nothing to me. This is just like another day, okay? This is not special. I talk to people all the time, especially Muslims.
Talk to yourself all the time.
And some of them, I do sometimes speak to deluded, arrogant, long-haired Irishmen as well. Sometimes I speak very shortly, for just a short space of time, because it says, don't answer a fool. You've got strong views. I listen and I respect. What? Who am I dividing? What should I be preaching? Love and acceptance. You can be a Hare Krishna. Go around, go Hare, Hare, Hare. Spliff, spliff, spliff. That's cool.
Should you preach that we should all be happy?
We should all preach having a face nappy or a chin shit. Holder upper.
You should definitely have a nappy.
We need the truth. Jesus claimed to be the truth. He didn't claim to be a truth. He claimed to be the truth. You've got to be honest. No?
People,
you're not honest.
We must reject.
You don't want to be honest.
This dividing type of people.
You're dividing people by wearing a face nappy.
He doesn't want to go anywhere.
Take your nappy off, go and read the Bible, and then you won't be ignorant. You won't be dividing. I'm getting people to think, don't wear a nappy. It won't do any good.
That's what I'm doing.
So, respect. Do you want me not to stick to facts? What do you want me to...
Why are you taking my patience?
God serious? Does not exist.
What I'm trying to say is maybe it would be a much better approach.
Religion exists.
How should I do it? And what's the approach?
So in a lot of monotheistic religions, the basis of it is all the same. Like whether you look at Christians...
All the same. You haven't read the Quran, have you? The Quran says Jesus did not die on the cross. He did not rise from the dead. He's not the Son of God. This book says he the Son of God, man. He gonna die on a cross. He's gonna defeat death as the Messiah. He's gonna rise from the dead. You are, if you wanna live a schizophrenic life, I used to be schizophrenic, but I'm okay now, and so am I. You can get jokes. Maybe you didn't get that one, but anyway. Now here's the key thing. We need to be consistent, we need to be honest, and we need to be sticking to the facts. The facts that the Quran says Jesus is not the Son of God. He's the Son of David, he's the Son of Man, and he's the Son of God. He proved it. He defeated death, lived a perfect life.